Cyanosis is a clinical sign characterized by a bluish or purplish discoloration of the skin, mucous membrane, or nail beds, often indicative of an underlying condition that leads to decreased oxygenation of the blood. This discoloration is primarily due to the presence of deoxygenated hemoglobin in the blood vessels near the skin's surface. This video covers the medical definition and provides a brief overview of this topic. So if you're ready, let's get into it. Under normal conditions, blood is bright red when it leaves the lungs full of oxygen. When the oxygen is used up by the body's tissues, the blood changes to a darker color. However, when the blood has significantly reduced oxygen levels, it becomes dark enough to change the color to a bluish hue, which is visible when observing areas where the skin is thin, such as lips, gums, or fingernail beds. Cyanosis is generally a symptom of an underlying condition rather than a disease itself. It's often associated with heart or lung conditions that impair the body's ability to adequately oxygenate the blood. Conditions such as COPD, pulmonary embolism, congenital heart defects, and pneumonia can lead to cyanosis. Moreover, cyanosis can also be caused by conditions that lead to poor blood circulation or a reduction in the oxygen-carrying capacity of the blood, such as severe anemia or poisoning by certain chemicals or drugs like carbon monoxide or certain narcotics. The onset and severity of cyanosis can vary widely depending on the underlying cause. For some, it may appear suddenly, indicating a medical emergency like a pulmonary embolism or a severe asthma attack. In others, it may develop slowly over time, as seen in conditions like COPD. Besides the visible discoloration, individuals with cyanosis might also exhibit symptoms related to the underlying cause, such as shortness of breath, fatigue, dizziness, or chest pain. Cyanosis is typically divided into two main types, central and peripheral. Central cyanosis is observed when there is a systemic decrease in arterial oxygen saturation, affecting the lips, tongue, and mucous membranes. It suggests a serious problem with the body's oxygenation system, often related to the lungs or heart. On the other hand, peripheral cyanosis is usually located to the extremities, like the fingers and toes, and can be a result of local problems that affect the circulation of blood to these areas, such as Raynaud's phenomenon or peripheral arterial disease. Peripheral cyanosis might be more apparent in cold temperatures and can be relieved by warming. Diagnosing and treating the underlying cause of cyanosis is crucial. A thorough medical history, physical examination, and various diagnostic tests, including pulse oximetry, arterial blood gas analysis, chest x-rays, and electrocardiograms are often utilized to determine the root cause. The treatment of cyanosis is directed at the underlying condition and may involve a range of interventions, from supplemental oxygen therapy and medications to surgical procedures, depending on the severity and nature of the condition. But as you can see, while cyanosis itself is not a disease, it serves as an important indicator of potential underlying health issues. Prompt recognition and appropriate evaluation of cyanosis are vital to ensure timely and effective treatment of the underlying cause, thereby preventing potential complications and ensuring better health outcomes. If you want to support the channel, please like and subscribe. I would greatly appreciate it. And there should be some other helpful videos popping up on your screen right about now that I think you will enjoy. And just a quick reminder, we are not doctors. This video is for informational purposes only. Thank you so much for watching. Have a blessed day. And as always, breathe easy, my friend.